In this short screencast, I'm going to remind you what a correlation is. So a correlation is a mathematical relationship based on experimental data that relates one or more inputs to an output. That's the important thing here is experimental. So a lot of these correlations, or most of these correlations, are experimentally derived. So let's go through a couple examples. Maybe somebody, a scientist, goes out there and looks at the density of something, maybe a gas, at different pressures. So they come up with this, the data here shown in blue, and then what they do is they set up a regression model. They create a regression model, maybe a polynomial or an exponential regression model that's shown in red that attempts to fit most of those data. And, you know, maybe the scientist comes up with density in grams per centimeter cubed is equal to 1.13 times the exponent of 1.2 times 10 to the negative 10th times the pressure. The important thing here is that the pressure is in pascals and the output, the density, is in grams per centimeter cubed. So the user creates this using the units that they choose. So they change pressure in pascals and they measure density in grams per centimeter cubed. In a follow-up screencast, we're going to show you how you can change this. So maybe you want to use pressure in atmospheres and you want to compute you want to be able to predict using this equation or a modified equation, the density in pounds per cubic foot or pounds, you know, something else, some other unit of measure for density. Another example, maybe the thermal expansion coefficient of water. So the scientist goes out there, collects data shown in red. They fit maybe a quick second order polynomial model and they get the following. The important thing here, thermal expansion is in per Kelvin and they put temperature in degrees Celsius. So in this model equation, you have to make sure temperature is in Celsius and the output's gonna be per Kelvin for the thermal expansion. Maybe another one, this is the density of water as a function of temperature, same thing. Maybe the experimenter goes out there, collects data, the data aren't shown, but you know, you might have a bunch of data points and it's not perfect, but you come up with a model that best fits those experimental data and the user gets this third order polynomial in temperature in Celsius to predict the density of water in kilograms per cubic meter. Finally, you might have the heat capacity of something like acetone in the gas phase. The experimenter adjusts or calculates the heat capacity at a bunch of different temperatures in degrees Celsius, and they measure the heat capacity in kilojoules per mole per degree Celsius. And again, in a follow-up screencast, I will show you how we can change this. Maybe the user wants to be able to use temperature in Fahrenheit to predict heat capacity in BTU per pound mole per degree Fahrenheit as an example. So again, this is a third order polynomial here. So the experimenter comes up with a model. There are different ways to create models, but they come up with a model and that is a correlation. And we use a lot of correlations in science and engineering.
I wanted to quickly mention one more thing about something that's important about these correlations. These coefficients, so A, B, C, and D, again, those are experimentally determined, but those actually have units. So remember, Cp in this example is in kilojoules per mole per degree Celsius. Temperature is in degrees Celsius. So as an example, A here has to be in units of, it's not multiplied by anything, it's not multiplied by temperature, so A is going to have units of kilojoules per mole degrees Celsius, just like Cp. Now, when B is multiplied by T, that has to have the units of Cp. So we can calculate the units that B has to be in. B times T has to be kilojoules per mole per degrees Celsius, right? That's what B times T is. So I'll just say like that's in units of B times degrees Celsius. So if I divided both sides by degrees Celsius, B then would be in units of kilojoules per mole degrees Celsius squared. All right, so that's what the units of B are. So when B is multiplied by C, we get one of those to cancel, and that product is in units of kilojoules per mole degrees Celsius. And we could do a similar analysis for C and D. But remember that those experimentally determined coefficients actually have units, but we typically do not express those units when we write it out as our correlation. Thanks for watching.